It's 2:15, or rather 2:20 by my watch, and we're going to discuss about Mexico today and not the World Cup.
Yeah, and not the World Cup. Mexico are playing today, but no, Mexico has got bigger news today.
Yeah.
Bigger than the World Cup. They've just elected a new president, a guy called AMLO, or nicknamed AMLO.
Absolutely. And what does that mean? And today we're going to discuss about what does that gentleman being elected as the new president, his ideology that he supports, and what all of these things mean for the relations with India.
Yeah.
Of all the countries.
On the basis, AMLO, if you guys have heard of him, he's a socialist, left-wing kind of guy, for the people, by the people, you know, one of those kind of people, one of those kind of politicians. And he's come to power on the basis of a very populist ideal, right? I want to help everyone. I want everyone to be okay. And Mexico is one of the poorer countries on the planet. Mm-hmm. Obviously, appeal to that idea.
Absolutely.
So what we're going to discuss is Mexico's relationship with India, which is surprisingly strong.
It's interesting, but it's also, if you're not into foreign policy, if you're not a student of foreign policy, if you've not been covering foreign policy, but the amount of importance Mexico has in terms of relations with this country is immense. I mean, look at that. I mean, let's look at some certain numbers. I mean, in terms of FDI from the Latin American countries, Mexico tops the list in terms of FDI into India. India tops the list in terms of FDI in Mexico from foreign countries from the group of Latin American countries. Those are crazy numbers. And not only that, India, look at the things India takes from there. India takes oil, India takes gold. India also has been taking a lot of seed from Mexico during
a lot
60s
of agricultural research.
Absolutely, 60s and 70s when the Green Revolution was happening in Punjab. And it's an old relationship that India has with
Mexico. Talk about the agricultural help, you know. Mexico's got very similar climates, very similar soil.
Yeah.
And I mean, there's a reason why the only agave plants, which is the tequila plants, that grow outside Mexico, grow in India.
Yeah.
There's a few in South Africa, but it's mostly, you know, Andhra Pradesh.
Yeah.
We've got our own agave liquor. So Mexico and India have a lot more in common than we would assume. We don't
absolutely
have any direct sea trade links or anything.
No sea or air links with Mexico and India.
But do you know this? This is one of the strangest facts we found while doing research with this. Mexico exports a lot of crude oil.
Yeah.
And their third biggest country they export to is India. Yeah, 76% of their exports to India are crude oil.
And having said that, and imagine these pointers that we're giving out to you. Put that on one side, and the other side, Narendra Modi became the first prime minister after Rajiv Gandhi to have actually gone and spent a day in Mexico
on a visit.
I mean, in spite of us having decent trade relationships with the country for so long.
So I think the reason this gets downplayed a lot is because our political relationship is not that important.
Yeah.
Mexico sitting all the way over there doesn't really help us with, you know, Pakistan or China. Whoever.
Yeah.
They're not big enough. They don't have nuclear weapons. They don't have a massive army or a navy.
Absolutely.
So that relationship is not as strong. But our economic ties are surprisingly strong. Because Mexico is a gateway to Latin America.
Absolutely. And here are the things. I mean, let's keep India for a bit, a couple of minutes, and talk about the quality of the Mexican workers, or even the rules and regulations that Mexico have. Let's give you one example. Let's take an example of the medical, all the laws related to manufacturing of medicines in Mexico. Now, here's the funny thing. Now, in Latin America, say if you are a company which produces, a pharmaceutical company which manufactures medicines, drugs, or whatever, all these things. And if you are certified by the Mexican authority, the equivalent pharmaceutical authority in Mexico, then you'll be allowed to sell not only across Latin America, but also in Europe, but interestingly, not in India. Also because Mexico the government buys all these medicines. I mean, they do not have like private shops and all of that. The government sells all these medicines. It's like a free-for-all medicine, but all these companies need to pass certain laws, and only then they're allowed to sell it back to the government. So the laws are so stringent, like, you know, if you're making a cough syrup, so A, B, C, D, E, F, you have to follow these five laws. And so the other Latin American companies, even the European Union, they're like, okay, you know, your rules are really good, you can sell it back to us.
Exactly, yeah.
Which is why I find it a little weird. I mean, why not then India? Why not sell it to India?
I mean, India's got a different... I mean, this is actually a good point, because it brings in America. America are the guys who export a lot of medicines, because they're the ones who innovate a lot in terms of medicines.
Yeah.
Now, India is using Mexico as not only a gateway to go south, but also to go north.
Oh, yes.
Especially in these times of American, you know, constant trade wars with everyone.
Yeah.
So India has got a lot of automotive companies moving into Mexico,
absolutely,
selling in Mexico and trying to go up.
And he's absolutely right. I mean, India is the largest exporter to Mexico for automobiles, whether it's a scooter or a bike or a car.
And it's another thing, you know, our energy sector, and not just oil,
yes,
but in terms of solar power, in terms of electrical energy,
mm-hmm.
In vehicles, all that is something that Mexico is very pro.
Mm-hmm.
And like we said earlier, they've got very similar climates to India,
yeah,
so solar energy works in that country.
Absolutely.
And we're one of the pioneers of
absolutely.
Cheap solar electricity.
Across the world today,
yeah.
I mean, in terms of the subsidies that we give out. I mean, it's a pro-solar policy we have. And not only that, I mean, if you look at the IT environment,
mm-hmm.
I mean, it wouldn't come occur naturally to you as a person. I mean, whatever you do across the world, like Mexican IT, you wouldn't put these two terms together. But there's actually a viable, IT
massive
community
IT
over there.
Community.
They have their own version of the valley over
there's
there.
There's 8,000, 9,000 jobs of just Indian IT companies. So the Infosys,
yeah.
TCS, Wipro.
Wipro, even HCL has centers.
Based around
there.
Guadalajara. So it's supposed to be the Silicon
absolutely.
Valley of Mexico, and it's all created from Indian IT imports.
Absolutely, and there might be some issues here and there. There are things like, now Mexico is a law which says it's 90 to 10, means, you know, the employees in an IT company over there, or say a foreign company like from India, an IT company from India goes and sets up base over there, only 10% will be workforce allowed from outside the border, like from India.
That makes
so
sense.
That creates an issue of the, availability of skilled workforce. You might not have that skilled workforce over there, so why not bring it from outside?
Yeah.
So that is something the country still needs to, I mean, it's between countries, they still need to look at that.
And I mean, speaking of business, Mexico, it has a bit of a crime problem.
Mm-hmm.
I think this we all know. Drugs, drug cartels tend to be strong in some of the rural areas.
Mm-hmm.
But the current government that's just been elected in has won 5 of 9 governor elections as well, including
mm-hmm.
Mexico City.
Yeah.
So these guys are clearly
mm-hmm.
pro-people, anti-violence, and
mm-hmm.
if they can clean up the streets,
yeah.
I mean, everyone knows, if you've got a peaceful city, you've got a clean city,
that's
absolutely. Always good for business.
Absolutely.
That's always good for India. I mean, these Indian companies might want to expand more if you give them assurances that no one's going to come in and break in and harass employees.
Absolutely. And it's a viable economy. If you look at, I mean, if especially you look at Latin America, look
mm-hmm.
at the other countries in Latin America and the kind of, trade agreements or business
mm-hmm.
relationships they have with other powerful nations across the world, any nation in the European Union or United States or India or any of these Asian nations, Mexico strangely has more FDI flowing in from Asian nations or from European nations than compared to any other Latin American economy over
Mexico
there.
Mexico really is, they're a model of stability in Americas.
Yeah.
Because even today, so the another thing that AMLO stands for
mm-hmm.
is, well, as a socialist, he's,
mm-hmm.
I mean, people are scared he's going to change a lot of this financial regulation. So he's been a little vague about what exactly his policies
mm-hmm.
are. He's just been going for the populist movement.
Yeah.
Now that he's in power, a lot of these guys in America, Wall Street and
mm-hmm.
all the bankers,
mm-hmm.
they realize that, okay, Mexico for a long time has been good to them. They've been very conservative with the
absolutely.
Economic policies. But now this guy might change it all. He might say, I want a bunch of subsidies for farmers in Mexico. So the easiest way to fund
mm-hmm.
all of this,
mm-hmm.
and you can look across
mm-hmm.
the world, if you've got oil, you sell it. That's how you fund social policies. That's what Venezuela did until the oil prices sank. India,
that's what Norway did. I mean,
Now, India, now we've just had Iran being shut off as an oil source because the Americans are in the middle of their big fight with Iran. They've told the Indians, listen, you can't buy oil from Iran anymore.
It's kind of weird, don't you think? I mean, Nikki Haley comes, flies down to India. 3 days of her visit into India, you see headlines across all global newspapers that India has decided to go the other way. I mean, it's just, I don't know.
Yeah, that's a different debate. Why we capitulated so easily to American demands or something else. But for now, Mexico might be something that can supplement this Iranian oil disappearance.
Absolutely.
Brazil, Mexico, these countries have a lot of oil.
Absolutely. Or tell you something, or why not even buy, remember the last time something like that with Iran happened, 3 or 4 years ago, when the entire issues with, like, you know, don't buy from Iran, don't do anything in any trade relations with Iran, cancel all your, I mean, okay, fine. I mean, it's not like a child's play, tomorrow you get up and cancel all the things. I mean, eventually it happened, but India did not actually stop buying oil for Iran per se. They did buy oil from Iran, but in a different currency altogether.
They're a little offshoots here.
Correct. And talk about Mexico. I mean, let's go back to the topic that we did mention to you about the relations with India and all, but even with US, I really find it funny more than strange, their relations with US. I mean, I was just going through some numbers on the embassy side. Mexico has the most number of consulates across America, more than 100 consulates across America.
I mean,
that is
crazy. That's the thing, right? Despite all the US and Trump rhetoric about, we need to build a wall, Mexicans are bad, and this and that, US desperately needs to help Mexico build a good economy.
Yeah.
Because if the Mexican economy collapses, they can talk about, oh, we're holding the Mexicans away. No, half the reason the Mexicans aren't getting into America is because the Mexican government themselves is patrolling the border and saying, listen, come back, turn back.
Yeah.
If the Mexicans decide to stop patrolling the border, or if their economy collapses and they can't patrol the border anymore, that's going to be a free-for-all, which is why America has tried for decades to help the Mexican government. But with Trump coming in and Trump being Trump, trying to remove all possible investment everywhere but America, Mexico is feeling the pinch. I mean, Trump's talking about removing their NAFTA agreement, which is in place since 1992.
Which is stupid. Honestly, this
India, as one of Mexico's bigger trading partners, needs to step in here. And
absolutely,
maybe can
they
step in
to.
Here.
I mean, look at the number of, if you look at the number of entrepreneurs, there are more than what? 7 to 8 million, and these are records on the embassy's website. Go and check it out. I mean, there are more than 7 to 8 million entrepreneurs from Mexico who have come to US some 20, 30 years ago, set up their business, and they're all millionaires. They're employing American citizens. They're employing for citizens not only in America, from American Indians and Asians all across the world who have stayed over there. And this entire border dispute that's happening, I think India really needs to play a little smaller foreign policy. In the last 4 months or so, it's gone a little haywire if you look at it, the kind of relations. I mean, if you take Iran out of the way, I mean, it should be really smart. I mean, and we have had relations with Mexico for the last 60 years, last 50, 60 years. It's not been
since independence. Yeah. It's not a major alliance or anything.
It's not like suddenly it has happened overnight.
It's a quiet trade alliance that's been happening for a long time. And it's an important one, because think about India is kind of surrounded by countries that wouldn't mind to see us fail. This is like Pakistan, China. Obviously, they don't want us to fail because they destabilize the global economy. But they don't want us to get too strong.
Absolutely. And it makes sense also. I mean, he's absolutely blunt, right? I mean, you know, he talked about neighbors. You look at all our neighbors with due respect. You look at a Pakistan or a Sri Lanka or, or a Thailand or even Nepal. Now, there's nothing alarming, but if you've seen the kind of trade agreements, if you've seen the kind of infrastructure agreements that China is building or has built already with these four countries, is beyond India's means. I mean, we haven't done anything like this in the last...
India is not a great proponent of trade agreements. We get involved if someone else creates it, but we don't go out and create these agreements very rarely. We've got one with Iran and Afghanistan for that Chabahar port, which is one of the greater deals we've done recently. But for the most part, India doesn't initiate economic deals. With the Mexican president coming in, with America trying to isolate everyone and isolate themselves.
There's a great chance for India to
India needs more trade alliances that won't collapse. Because Mexico is a very strong one. People underestimate it. Mexico is America's, I mean, top, I think the third biggest trade partner.
Yes.
Or second biggest trade partner. So Mexico is a very powerful country in that sense. They're a gateway to two different continents.
Yeah.
They're very open. They want to be open despite having a socialist president and having all these Americans worry about it. They are here to be part of the world.
Absolutely. Because it doesn't happen. I mean, since the type of government, I mean, the particular ideology that this current government, which is going to come into power now, is based on, if it doesn't go for proper, stronger trade agreements, these bilateral treaties with especially countries like India, who ideally should welcome Mexico and all the stuff that Mexico has. When I say stuff, these are minerals. I mean, these are allowing companies from here to go set up base over there. You know, and oil, of course. India is an oil-hungry nation. We need oil.
We need a lot.
If we don't do that and Mexico says, no, we'll go the socialist way, we'll have things like that.
Oh, wait, okay, that's just a little context. When we say socialist, we don't mean full-blown Cuba or Soviet Union. We mean just a guy who's for socialist policies. In his
I mean, pro-people policies.
Yeah, pro-welfare policies.
What do you mean to say? If you don't... Mexico is already decently built now. And apart from, I mean, they've somehow, you know, they have come back from all the wars that has happened. I mean, when I say these are civil wars which have fought because of the drug lords over there. Now, if they don't open up to other countries, it might go the Venezuela way in spite of having a lot of resources.
Yeah, so they need to, so Mexico, and this is something AMLO has talked about as well, is they need to, you know, stop the reliance on exporting oil.
Yeah.
Because if you do, if you rely on one specific export, then obviously you need to diversify.
Absolutely.
I mean, weirdly enough, tequila is another big one for them, because people around the world love tequila, and when you can, and you're the only country who can make it,
why not?
That's a great soft power
why
to
not?
Have.
Why not?
If our it's government good. Collapses, you get no more tequila. That's enough for the entirety of Europe to support Mexico.
So, you know, this is what foreign policies have come to in 2018.
Yeah. It's, I mean,
you import tequila, you have a great economy. If
I mean,
you don't,
can you imagine if the French government says, "Yeah, we're not supporting the Mexican government"? And French people go, but what happens to our tequila? No more tequila. They go, no, support the Mexican government.
I think a certain Putin will make a call. But I mean, to sum this entire thing up, Mexico is a very I mean, it's a very important trade partner considering what's been happening in the last 6 or 7 months.
And they're stable. They're a very stable trade partner.
In terms of relations with India and other countries. I'm not saying that.
No one's going to assume the Mexican government's going to fall anytime soon. Yeah. They've got control over their country.
Absolutely. They have natural resources. They already are a trade partner to not only us, but to other countries. They're part of G20.
Yeah.
And they've done business worth of $8 billion so far. That's what the current ambassador was quoted saying in an article in Financial Express.
Yeah.
And it might go to over $10 billion in the next couple of years. So there's nothing, and with the Iran thing happening, there's nothing stopping India from increasing their treaties with Mexico.
Considering India's part of our biggest economic alliance is BRICS.
Yeah.
Across the entire planet.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's necessary that we get some Central American influence in there.
It's
We've
like
Brazil, but no one else from
exactly.
Latin America.
It's like what India is doing with Ireland right now in terms of sending most of their IT companies over there. And like, you know what? Ireland, pardon me, Ireland says, you know, we're big enough, the Ireland Development Authority, they keep coming to India and promoting the entire culture of come here, build here, because after Brexit, Ireland has been the smartest nation on earth. It's like, Brexit has happened, let me be the gateway to Europe for all IT companies from Asia. Same as Mexico.
Yeah.
Mexico should be the gateway to Latin America or even North America for that matter.
I mean, going back to what we were talking about initially, going back to the 60s and 70s, the Green Revolution, Mexico helped us out so much.
Mm-hmm.
We can do the same thing in reverse. Right?
Yeah.
They have similar diet sources. They eat a lot of rice. They eat a lot of chicken.
Yeah.
These are things, a lot of vegetables that are similar here and there.
Absolutely.
These are things that we can provide to them as well. How
Absolutely.
Do they grow better rice? I mean, because India is famous for our strains of rice that we grew in the 60s and 70s.
Yeah.
Averted a global hunger crisis.
Absolutely. This is famous. I mean, he's right. I mean, to end it, I mean, there is a famous comment from the Mexican ambassador to India in this article. I think there's an interview in The Wire by Siddharth Vardarajan of Mexico's ambassador. And this lady says, you know, we had the seeds, but you had the soil. So why can't we vice or reverse right now?
Yeah, exactly. Why can't we help them the way they helped us?
Absolutely. So apart from the fact that India should have more relations, open up more relations with Mexico in terms of food, IT, aerospace, science and whatnot.
Yeah.
You also need to support, if you're an Indian, the Mexico team is going to play today.
Yeah.
Also important.
I like Brazil. But apart from that.
Apart from that. Well, that's been the business here at the Big Scope today. We'll catch you same time, same place tomorrow with yet another weird but extremely important topic for the country.